Leonardo Abdu, 79, has lived with fistula for 62 years. It has been a hard past 6 decades for her, marred with shame, fear, discrimination and stigma from both her family and community. What started out as something she thought was witchcraft persisted for years. Even worse, Abdu has missed many opportunities to undergo surgery because no one would volunteer to be her caretaker.
Mama alikungamba okuva myaka ja okuva myaka ejo paka kati. Yabadde afunanga ko just obu isopiso wa kumu
bangi anjabanga ku.
Ate abeeramu katugambe mama alinga isolation bamususula bisere bisingo bungi abeerawo yeka.
Sunday Ozera, 32, a fistula survivor from Nebbi District, contracted the condition after losing her firstborn at 17. She is currently in her third marriage as the first two husbands ran away in fear of her condition.
I stay at a home. The challenge is very, very bad. I'm leaking urine all the time and people, they are just fearing me. The operation was done 9 times. Up to now, I'm somehow okay.
Ozera has lived with fistula for 15 years and has undergone 9 surgeries.
I got married again. Even that husband doesn't know that I'm leaking urine. I didn't tell him because I know that if I tell him, he's going to leave me again with my condition.
According to the Uganda Demographic and Health Survey, 2% of Ugandan women aged 15 to 49 experienced an obstetric fistula. Obstetric fistula happened during a long and obstructed labor. The pressure caused by obstructed labor damages the tissue of the internal passages of the bladder and rectum. With no access to cesarean section and emergency obstetric care, the woman may be left permanently incontinent. This means being unable to hold urine or feces. The Ministry of Health estimates that at least 200,000 women in Uganda are living with fistula and that they register 1,900 new cases annually. During the commemoration of the World Fistula Day, the government pledged to close gaps leading to rising cases of fistula.
As a community in Namayengo, we play a key role in the first delay. The first delay is our responsibility as a community. So all of us have got a role to play at that level. Let us make sure that when a mother has gotten pregnant, we automatically at that point in time link them into care. Let them start accessing antenatal care services. And it's from that that the whole entire birth preparedness plan is constructed.
Country representative of the United Nations Population Fund, the organization championing the fight against fistula in Namayengo district, said she was surprised by the number of women suffering from what she termed as preventable complications.
When women delay in seeking care, it also contributes to the outcome. We are also concerned about the issue of teenage pregnancy, which we know is also high in this district. We know that when young girls become pregnant, the risk of complications is higher than if they were adults. So in line with the theme for 2024, which is breaking the cycle, preventing fistula worldwide, ending obstetric fistula is a priority for UNFPA.
Pregnant women need to have access to quality prenatal and antenatal care and be able to access emergency obstetrics. But prevention is also key. So we see that teenage pregnancies are also quite linked to obstetric fistula. And so reducing the teenage pregnancy rates in this country is of course key in preventing the high frequency of obstetric fistula.
Passes Namuganza, the State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development, who delivered Deputy Prime Minister Rebecca Kadaga's message, cautioned against teenage pregnancies, poor healthcare systems and low levels of education that facilitate fistula.
She said that government efforts are directed towards improving services through the following. One, to highlight the challenges in the delivery of specialized services in order to address them for improved care. Two, identify gaps through accurate profiling of maternal services.
Fistula can be treated through a surgery. These surgeries are currently free in Uganda referral hospitals and cost about 2 million Uganda shillings in private hospitals. The story is compiled by John Musenze for New Vision.